For a topical guide to this subject, see Outline of Economics. Economics is the social science that describes the factors that determine the production, distribution, and consumption of goods and services. The term economics comes from the ancient Greek omicron kappa omicron nu omicron mu iota alpha from omicron kappa omicron sigma and nu omicron mu omicron sigma, hence, rules of the house. Political economy was the earlier name for the subject, but economists in the late 19th century suggested economics as a shorter term for economic science to establish itself as a separate discipline. Outside of political science and other social sciences, economics focuses on the behavior and interactions of economic agents and how economies work. Consistent with this focus, primary textbooks often distinguish between microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics examines the behavior of basic elements in the economy, including individual agents and markets, their interactions, and the outcomes of interactions. Individual agents may include, for example, households, firms, buyers, and sellers. Macroeconomics analyzes the entire economy and issues affecting it, including unemployment of resources, inflation, economic growth, and the public policies that address these issues. Other broad distinctions within economics include those between positive economics, describing what is, and normative economics, advocating what ought to be, between economic theory and applied economics, between rational and behavioral economics, and between mainstream economics and heterodox economics. Besides the traditional concern in production, distribution, and consumption in an economy, economic analysis may be applied throughout society, as in business, finance, healthcare, and government. Economic analyses may also be applied to such diverse subjects as crime, education, the family, law, politics, religion, social institutions, war, science, and the environment. Education, for example, requires time, effort, and expenses, plus the foregone income and experience. Yet these losses can be weighted against future benefits education may bring to the agent or the economy. At the turn of the 21st century, the expanding domain of economics in the social sciences has been described as economic imperialism. The ultimate goal of economics is to improve the living conditions of people in their everyday life. Definitions. There are a variety of modern definitions of economics. Some of the differences may reflect evolving views of the subject or different views among economists. Scottish philosopher Adam Smith defined what was then called political economy as an inquiry into the nature and causes of the wealth of nations, in particular as, and to supply the state or commonwealth with a revenue for the public services. J. B. Say, distinguishing the subject from its public policy users, defines it as the science of production, distribution, and consumption of wealth. On the satirical side, Thomas Carlyle coined the dismal science as an epithet for classical economics in this context, commonly linked to the pessimistic analysis of Malthus. John Stuart Mill defines the subject in a social context as the science which traces the laws of such of the phenomena of society as arise from the combined operations of mankind for the production of wealth, insofar as those phenomena are not modified by the pursuit of any other object. Alfred Marshall provides a still widely cited definition in his textbook Principles of Economics that extends analysis beyond wealth and from the societal to the microeconomic level. Economics is a study of man in the ordinary business of life. It inquires how he gets his income and how he uses it. Thus, it is on the one side, the study of wealth and on the other and more important side, a part of the study of man. Lionel Robbins developed implications of what has been termed perhaps the most commonly accepted current definition of the subject. Economics is a science which studies human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means which have alternative uses. Robbins describes the definition as not classificatory in picking out certain kinds of behavior, but rather analytical in focusing attention on a particular aspect of behavior. The form imposed by the influence of scarcity, he affirmed that previous economists have usually centered their studies on the analysis of wealth, how wealth is created, distributed, and consumed, and how wealth can grow. But he said that economics can be used to study other things, such as war, that are outside its usual focus. This is because war has as the goal winning it, generates both cost and benefits, and resources are used to attain the goal. If the war is not winnable or if the expected costs outweigh the benefits, the deciding actors may never go to war but rather explore other alternatives. We cannot define economics as the science that studies wealth, war, crime, education, and any other field economic analysis can be applied to, but as the science that studies a particular common aspect of each of those subjects. Some subsequent comments criticize the definition as overly broad in failing to limit its subject matter to analysis of markets. From the 1960s, however, such comments abated as the economic theory of maximizing behavior and rational choice modeling expanded the domain of the subject to areas previously treated in other fields. There are other criticisms as well, such as in scarcity not accounting for the macroeconomics of high unemployment. Gary Becker, a contributor to the expansion of economics into new areas, describes the approach he favors as combining the assumptions of maximizing behavior, stable preferences, and market equilibrium, used relentlessly and unflinchingly. One commentary characterizes the remark as making economics an approach rather than a subject matter, but with great specificity as to the choice process and the type of social interaction that such analysis involves. The same source reviews a range of definitions included in principles of economics textbooks and concludes that the lack of agreement need not affect the subject matter that the texts treat. Among economists more generally, it argues that a particular definition presented may reflect the direction toward which the author believes economics is evolving, or should evolve.